Good evening, everybody. I'm back at Premier League HQ in the Matchday Live studio tonight. I'm hosting Wolves against Manchester United, and I have Ian Wright and Owen Hargreaves with me. Cannot wait. It's going to be loads and loads of fun, so come and join us. We'll also be keeping an eye on Watford against Fulham. Of course, Fulham could be relegated tonight, so come and join us. We are on air at 7 o'clock.
United all day.
Right, we'll see you in a bit. Hello, everybody. It's half time. Wolves, Manchester United. Look who I'm with. Righty and knowing. We've been having Jaffa cakes, cups of tea. How are you feeling, guys?
Good.
Excited about the second half?
Yeah, I just need Wolves to win.
Hello, it's time for the walk. The walk. No, don't worry, it's fine. People move out the way. It's so funny because I think they can't be in this Insta video, but I love it when they are. All about Tottenham today. We are building up to the big game, their first game. Look, there's Holly. Holly, hello. Everyone tries to hide. No, I love people in the here. I'll open the door for you. After you. So yes, building up to Tottenham against Crystal Palace. Tottenham's first game in their new home. Really, really excited about it. I have Darren Anderton in the studio with me. We've got Danny Jameson at the stadium, so we're going to get an insight into what it's like there. Lots to get through. Come and join us.
Hello! Yes, made it into the lift and made it onto my Insta story from my elevator story. How are you? Hope you're very well. Three games to look forward to today. Bournemouth, Burnley, Newcastle, Crystal Palace and Huddersfield, Leicester. We are going to be focusing on all of
the special recognition award. And to present this award, may I please request Vikram Banerjee, Director of Strategy and Corporate Development, Nick Pride, Interim Director of Participation in Growth, and BBC and Premier League presenter, Seema Jasper!
Genuinely shocked to be up here. I just want to thank the ECB, Nick, Vikram. National Age Cricket Council was set up for the Asian community. Being a huge voice, you know, we make up 35% of all cricket played in this country. And, you know, we just set up to be a voice of the Asian community. And to be fair, we've got a really fantastic partner in the ECB who listened and helped and supported us. And I know we've got multi-sport room here, but from a cricketing family, I think we've got all things right. We're on a great journey, but you know, the Asian cricketing community is a really influential part of cricket in this community, and we just want to be a voice for them and represent them. So, ECB, thank you very much.
One minute until we're on air. It's me and Lee. There we go. Right, come and join us on Fan Zone. Lots to discuss. See you in five. Good afternoon, everybody. It's time for Fan Zone. And we're going to be discussing Tottenham. A great win for them in their new home last night against Manchester City. We'll talk Liverpool as well. We're basically talking about the Premier League teams in Champions League action. And I'm Dean Ashton. So come and join us. We are on air in 15 minutes. See you then. Bye. Hello, guys. Back in familiar surroundings in the elevator. It's kickoff time and I'm back. Very excited to be here. Kickoff is going to be brilliant. Lots to talk about. We are at the new Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. Tottenham against Huddersfield. Join us for all the build-up. I am going to go and watch all of the managers' interviews now and get ready for the show. See you in a bit. Hello guys, well, it's time for Fan Zone. Come and join us. Well. We're this on air in a couple of minutes. Well, lots to discuss. Six games in the Premier League.
Never been the same since
the madness, the drama continues. I've got Don and Leroy with me. So I'll see you in five.
Take on me. Take on me. I'll be gone.
Good evening, everybody. I'm in the Matchday Live studio. There we go. It's a huge game in the Premier League at the bottom of the table. Brighton against Cardiff. You don't want to miss it. Come and join us. I'm with Andy Townsend and Alan Kirbishley. We're on air. Hello, everybody. On the way to the studio with Emil Heskey.
Hey.
Yes, we've never fan zoned together, have we?
No, we haven't. We're
really looking forward to
one today, haven't we?
We are. We're talking about a subject very close to your heart.
Yep.
We're talking about top goal scorers. Who's going to get it this season? Who do you think?
Salah. I think he's definitely on the ascendant, so I think he'll get it.
Well, let's find out if you agree with that. See you in about five.
It is indeed that time of the season where we can start discussing the race for the Golden Boot. Currently, it's Aguero and Salah that occupy the top spot, but the chasing pack are not too far behind. We're here to discuss it all on Fan Zone, so thank you very much for joining us. I'm in great company today. In fact, the perfect person to talk about goal scoring, Emil Heskey, with us. Welcome along to Fan Zone.
So we are in the green room, about to go on air in about 10 minutes.
Yep.
It's all about Champions League tonight, isn't it?
Yes.
So what do you think is going to happen between Manchester City and Tottenham?
I think City are going to be too strong. Very, very dynamic going forward. Going to be too much for Spurs. I do think Spurs are going to score, but I think City are going to come out winners, probably 3-1.
Great prediction. And what about for Liverpool? They play Porto.
Liverpool game, going into that 2-0 up, pretty comfortable. So I'm guessing probably another 2-0.
Lovely. Well, we'll have to wait and see. See you soon. Good morning, everybody. How are we? So we are on kickoff half an hour earlier today. Lots of exciting things to come. We are building up to Manchester City against Tottenham. What a game that could be. So I am actually, in about 15 minutes' time, I'm going to be on the Women's World Football Show. I'm actually voicing it. Claire Balding is hosting it. So make sure you tune in. That's on Channel 4. And then later on, once I leave here, I'm off to Sheffield for the World Super Championships. What a day. Cannot wait. I'll see you soon.
So they desperately needed a win against Tavernaco to keep the ball rolling. Seema Jaswal can tell us about that match.
The current league leaders began the match on the front foot, taking the lead after just 11 minutes. Aurora Galli found herself...
I made it. There she is. Look at the crucible. Wow, I am so, so excited. Looking forward to hosting the highlights tonight in this bad boy, the crucible. See you in a bit. Good morning, everybody. My first morning studio show with Steve Davis. He looks so happy. So we are on air in about 4 minutes. See you then. Good afternoon, everybody. So I'm not on Instagram, social media or reporting duties this time at the Crucible, but it does not mean I can't show you what's going on. Look at this. It is an absolutely stunning, stunning, beautiful day. In fact, I don't really want to move. I wish we could move the studio outside. Have a look at this. Look at that. This is what it's like. So that's the Winter Garden there where it says Welcome to Sheffield. This is a little square. And there is the Crucible. Really busy today on Easter Sunday. Absolutely gorgeous. And then there's a screen. Where? Oh no, that's the screen. Where you can watch all of the action. Absolutely beautiful. You enjoyed my first Good Morning Show with Steve Davis. I certainly did, and I'm back for the highlights tonight and back for another morning show tomorrow. Hello, good evening, everybody. How are we? Hope you've had a lovely day. Hope you've been enjoying the snooker. I'm in the studio. I'll show you what it looks like. There we go. Got a snooker table. There's the team. Hi, team.
Hey.
Hey. There we go. There you go. Just talking to myself. This is actually the practice room where all the players come and warm up. And this is also where we filmed the highlights show. So we're on air at, nearly breaking things. We're on air at 11:35, so come and join us then. Well, that was not your average morning at the World Snooker Championships, was it? What an incredible match. And it's only round one. Well, James Cahill, congratulations to him, because he just showed so much confidence. There was no sign of him slowing down. I spoke to him afterwards. He was just brilliant, brilliant to watch. I felt gutted for Ronnie though at the same time. I hope he feels better, and I really do. He will be missed for sure, but this tournament is just going to be brilliant, and I'm just so excited to be part of it. I hope you enjoyed our coverage this morning. Thanks for joining me on BBC Two, and I'll be back tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock, but Hazel's there now, taking you through to 6 o'clock. Enjoy it. It's just amazing, and Sheffield is beautiful. The sun is shining. I am loving it. Apparently, it's going to rain tomorrow. Oh, look, just down one of the streets outside the Crucible's just behind me, just there. Anyway, hope you've had as much fun as we have. Hello guys, we are all set and ready for the highlights. The crew are as well. There we go, all giving a nice wave. This is the studio stroke practice room that we do the highlights show in, and we're on air at 11:15. I'll see you then.
Crucible are on 12 big matchups in world ranking events. They've seen a lot of one another here.
Good morning guys. Sorry, I haven't actually caught up with you guys that much on Instagram lately because it's been very busy indeed, but we've just finished the morning show and it's been brilliant. I was in the studio with Steve Davis. Thanks for all of your lovely tweets and everything. This is actually where the practice room is, just behind me. We've got loads of pictures of lots of the top 16 players on the wall, which is great, if I can get out the door. And that's the stage door. And let me just show you around. The Crucible's amazing, by the way. It's brilliant. Players' dressing rooms that way. And this bit, which I haven't shown you this year, I showed you it last year, gives you all the past champions, the whole list of them. Oh, look, there's one of them.
Little story, is it? Little story. Backstage tour.
I'll see you tonight.
Yes.
7 o'clock. Well, there you go. That was perfect timing. It wasn't even planned. Anyway, yes, thanks for all of the love. Well, that was hilarious. That's what it's like here at the Crucible. You're always bumping into all of the legends and all the past players and current players, and it's like one big family. Well, I am now getting ready to go, and then I'll be back in a few hours because I'm hosting the live show at 7 o'clock. So, and I'll be with Stephen Hendry for that one. So make sure you join us there as the quarterfinals continue. It's been great so far. Can't wait to see you later. Bye.